How bacteria can move toward light has always been a mystery, but now a team of researchers found that each organism uses its entire body to refract and focus light. You know, like your eyeballs. I often wonder, how do those monstrous slimes or gelatinous cubes move toward me in a dungeon? They don't have eyes. After 300 years of research, science has finally found the answer. The world's smallest example of an eye. We already knew that certain cyanobacteria move towards light sources, like say a torch, but we didn't know how they detected it. Thanks to a team of British and German researchers whose work was published in the journal eLife in February of 2016, we now know that while cyanobacteria's biological structures are different from ours, the physical principles for how they sense light are actually quite similar to how we humans do it. But first, what the heck are cyanobacteria? Well, they're single-cell blue-green bacteria that are pretty common in underwater environments. You know, that slippery green film you find on underwater rocks? This study specifically looked at the species called Synechocystis, found in fresh lakes and rivers. By testing a mutant version of this bacteria, that's right, I said mutant, that accumulates green fluorescent proteins, the researchers were able to learn that each cell body acts like a lens. Light hits its spherical surface and then refracts on the other side of the cell with intense focus. This triggers the cell's photoreceptors, which cue the cell to steer toward the light. Now, the moving. That's the creepy part. The bacteria each grow tiny little tentacles called pili that reach out toward the light. The pili tentacles only form on the side facing the light source, attaching to the surface they're on, and then retracting to pull the bacteria along. While the light refraction principle is essentially similar to human vision, a Synechocystis cell is about 3/1000ths of a millimeter across, half a billion times smaller than the human eye. So its resolution is low and can only perceive blurred outlines of objects. Kind of like when I take my glasses off. So is this evidence of an evolutionary connection between bacteria and people? Do other bacteria see the same way? And how will this help me in my future battles against gelatinous cubes and elder black puddings? Let us know what you think. And to keep up with the latest science research and my fate in the slave pits of the Undercity, make sure to visit us at now.howstuffworks.com every day.